Clergymen pretended to be the teachers of God. Laymen are only listeners and trust that the teachings of the clergymen are in agreement with the word of God. They do not use efforts to test it with the Bible. Before I was an active student of the Bible, I was Catholic and never read the Bible. I believed the teachings of the clergyman, that God is a Trinity. We have an immortal soul. The earth is a passage to heaven. I had fear for hell and purgatory. Jehovah's Witnesses showed me in the Bible what it really teaches, and I came to know that God is love and never tortured people in hell. Jehovah's Witnesses showed me in the Bible that the future will be the kingdom of God with a heavenly government over the earth. God created a beautiful earth with all his provisions for mankind, with the prospect of eternal life. The first humans wanted to be independent from God, with the painful result we now experience it. Christ Jesus provided with great love for mankind in a sacrifice with his own life to restore what is lost. After the sinfall in Eden, many prophecies are gradually fulfilled, so we can be sure that the restoration of what is lost is near. We can soon expect that a new government in heaven will take over the power. Then we'll start the restoration of the earth in agreement with its purpose for mankind by the creation. The lookout will be for mankind, full health with eternal life in peace and security for everyone. If you personally study the teachings of Jehovah God in his guidebook, the Bible, must it be clear that the clergyman deviate from true Bible teachings. It is Jehovah God, not the clergyman, that provided in the happy future. How important it is to know by our study of the Bible what is the real and full truth of God. By your study of the Bible, you will come to know what God from you required to do his will, with the prospect of eternal life in the future. If we really want to know the real truth of God, and we will be not misled by false doctrines, we need to let us teach by Jehovah God as the one teacher. Christ Jesus warned the pretended teachers at this time. He let us know in Matthew 23, verse 8, for one is your teacher, whereas all you are brothers. His warning words before and after his sayings in Matthew 23, verse 8 are, but you, do not you be called rabbi. Do not call anyone your father. Neither be called leaders. But the greatest one among you must be your minister. It must be clear that all of us must be his humble students. Jesus Christ is also an humble student of God, as he explained for himself in John 8, verse 50 and verse 28. But I am not seeking glory for myself. You will know that I do nothing of my own initiative, but just as the Father taught me, I speak these things. What a humble student of his father. Only from God is coming accurate knowledge. His only one mediator is Christ Jesus. Knowing the real truth is the result of our own efforts. What presumptuous to say that the teaching of the Bible is not complete. Can we use indications to teach a doctrine? Christ Jesus condemned powerful deviations from the scriptures. Paul warned us in 1 Corinthians 4, verse 6, do not go beyond the things that are written. This is a warning for us of not using doctrines without the full Bible support. This must have the support of the context and be in agreement with the complete Bible with two or more witnessing. If we have attention for God's wisdom, will the teacher, Jehovah God, sending his Holy Spirit for knowledge and discernment, to understand all things, even the deep things of God, as we read in 1 Corinthians 2 verse 10. The question can be, why do we not find the word organization in the Bible? We do not know it. In Isaiah 55 verse 8 we read that Jehovah God's thought is not the same as our thought. Brother Russell teaches no organization. Brothers work in love together. He had obvious in mind the words of Christ Jesus in Matthew 23 verse 8. Then the proclamation of Brother Rutherford. The Watchtower Society is the organization of God. Letters addressed to the society started with Dear Mother. In 1978, the proclamation, a governing body as different from the legal corporation. Now is the teaching of only a heavenly organization with an earthly part. We know all what is originated by God is perfect. How is it to understand that God's organization needed adaptations because of not sufficient light? How can we understand Christ Jesus' words in Matthew 28, verse 19-20, I am with you all the days until the conclusion of the system of things? Refer it to God's organization? Or is with you to understand the ones that teach and make disciples from the first century onward? To promote at this time worldwide activities is the establishment needed of a legal organization. Is that the credit for the results, the society as organization? Or is the credit for the worldwide brotherhood? The ones with responsibilities at the society together with the ones scattered over the world in the many congregations. Jehovah God expects from us that we worship in agreement with the truth, and that we are his witnesses for the truth. More information is to read in the website thebibletruthweb.info. We know that the expected new world must be very near. We know Peter's words in 2 Peter 3 verse 11 and 14. What sort of persons ought you to be in holy acts and conduct and deeds of godly devotion? Do your utmost to be found finally by him spotless and unblemished and in peace. These words accented that we are personally responsible for approval.